Hello friends, welcome back. Today we are going to read about a very interesting topic. Name of that topic is cellular aging. Okay. So everyone knows that this is a very famous Indian actor. Okay, she is Rekha, as you all know. Can you guess her age? How much do you think? You must be having some idea, right? You will not believe, but she is 65 years of age. Okay, let me give you one example. This is for the international audience. You must be knowing who is she. Yes, she is Meryl Streep. Okay, now what do you think? How much is her age? 71 years. Okay, so as you can guess from the caption, today's lecture is based on age. Is age just a number? Why certain people, even after so many years of living life, why they are appearing so young? And why some people who are so young, they appear to be so old? So this is the question that I want to answer today with my PowerPoint. Okay, let's start. So today we are reading about cellular aging. Okay, so today let us see. So what is actually cellular aging? Why we want to read? Why is it that we want to know about aging? Because scientists around the world, they have found that aging has the strongest and it is the most independent risk factor for many chronic diseases. Okay, for many chronic diseases. That is why as and when you age, okay, you develop multiple diseases. Okay, all problems, they begin in old age. Okay, now for example, we can see cancers, we can see Alzheimer's disease, we can see ischemic heart disease. All of them has an association with aging. So it is of great interest to know about the process of aging. So aging is what? It is a result of progressive decline in the cell function and viability because of two main factors. Okay, one of them, we can have certain genetic abnormalities, and second, there can be accumulation of cellular and molecular damage because of exposure to environmental influences. So during our life, okay, we are exposed to so many environmental influences, so many chemicals, okay, air pollutants, okay, so these all have a cumulative effect on our age over the years. Okay, so there are four basic mechanisms which explain aging process. One is DNA damage. Second is cellular senescence. Third is defective protein homeostasis. And fourth is deregulated nutrient sensing. Okay, so we are going to discuss each one of them in details. Okay, so let's move forward. Okay, first we are going to discuss about DNA damage. So first, very important thing is that what are the causative agents which causes the DNA damage? So we have the physical, chemical, biological agents, and also we had read about the reactive oxygen species. I have made a special lecture on free radicals and reactive oxygen species. Please go and look at that lecture. Okay, so all these things, all the physical, chemical, biological and reactive oxygen species, they will cause DNA damage. Okay, and what will happen whenever there is a DNA damage inside the cell? There are two pathways. Okay, first, the body will attempt at DNA repair, and if the DNA repair is successful, well and good, the cell will continue to divide, cell cycle will continue, everything is fine, everyone is happy. But what if the DNA repair will fail? If the DNA repair fails, now the DNA is prone to mutations. Okay, so once the DNA repair will fail, okay, the DNA will undergo, it is actually very prone and sensitive to different kind of mutations. Okay, and slowly, steadily, these mutations is going to accumulate over the years. And this is the reason why cancers occur in the old age. Hope you have understood. Now we go a little forward, the same slide. We will have something extra. So what is extra in this slide? This slide is very similar to the previous slide, but there are few clinical implications that I have given in this particular slide. So there are two clinical applications actually of DNA damage, of this aspect of DNA damage and aging. So there are two conditions, very important MCQ for NEET PG, very important to know even in the exam viva question, both for undergraduate as well as postgraduate education. If you see, number one is the Werner syndrome. Okay, Werner syndrome. What happens in Werner syndrome? In Werner syndrome, a DNA repair enzyme, okay, called as DNA helicase is deficient. So what will happen if DNA repair will not take place? There will be a rapid accumulation of mutations, okay, and ultimately which can give rise to cancer. So these patients are very prone to mutations and cancer. Second is Bloom syndrome and ataxia telangiectasia. So what is the problem over here? Actually, the genes which are actually involved in synthesizing the proteins, which in turn participates in repairing. Okay, repairing what? Repairing the double-stranded DNA break. So there is a very particular kind of DNA breaks. Isko bolte hain, we call it as double-stranded DNA breaks. And most of these double-stranded DNA breaks are caused by UV rays. So whenever you are going out in the sun, you will suffer some damage. So when I am saying environmental influences, even means when you are going out of your home for usual activities, okay? And then usually what will happen? Usually we have DNA repair genes, okay, which is going to repair the double-stranded DNA breaks induced by the UV rays. But in persons who is suffering from Bloom syndrome or ataxia telangiectasia, they will show premature aging. They will show cancers at a very younger age. Okay, why? Because they accumulate a lot of mutations in these times. Okay, let us go to the next slide. Okay, so first aspect, DNA damage, is clear. Now we go to the second aspect of cellular senescence. Okay, let us understand what is cellular senescence. Okay, so what we understand is that all the cells in our body, they can undergo a finite number of cell divisions, means they have a life. Okay, they are not immortal. Okay, all human beings, all of us, we are not immortal. Okay, we are human beings and we have a expiry date. All of us will die one day or the other. So all cells in our body, they have a finite life, meaning they will undergo certain number of divisions, and after that cell division will be arrested and they will die. This is the normal process. Okay, so that means what? That they will divide a fixed number of times. Okay, this process, okay, after a certain period of cell division, the cell will come in a stage of replicative senescence. What does it mean? It means it is a stage wherein the cell cannot divide any further. It is a permanent non-dividing state. Okay, and there are two mechanisms which can explain a cellular senescence. One of them is telomere attrition, and second is activation of tumor suppressor gene. So there are two basic mechanisms which control cellular senescence. Okay, let us go forward. First, we will discuss about the telomere attrition. So under telomere attrition, let us see. So this is the same slide, but we are starting with the telomere attrition. So this is the portion where we are beginning with the telomere attrition. So first of all, we can see over here, there is one diagram of something. What is this? Tell me. This is classically our chromosome. Now you will see that the ends of the chromosome, if you see, I have marked it as red, and these parts are actually called as the telomere. These parts are called as the telomere. So the end of the chromosomes are called as telomeres. Now what are telomeres? These are actually a short repetitive DNA sequence, okay, present at the chromosomal ends. Okay, and telomere, what is the basic function of the telomere? The basic function of the telomere is to encode an enzyme telomerase. Very important is this enzyme telomerase. And what is the main activity of this enzyme telomerase? It protects this chromosomal end, that is the telomere, from degradation, and also helps in DNA replication. Okay, it will also help in replication. So remember, there is a gene. The gene is called as a telomere. Okay, and this gene is present at the end of the chromosome. Okay, now there is one enzyme which is encoded by this gene telomere. Isko bolte hain, we call it as telomerase. And the function of this telomerase is to prevent the degradation of this telomere. Okay, and till this telomere is protected, the cell will keep on dividing. Okay, the cell will keep on dividing. Okay, we will understand about this further in our next slide. Let us look at this slide. We are continuing with the telomere attrition. So what is happening over here, as soon as the cell will start to divide, okay, with every cycle, what happens normally, this is the normal process that I'm speaking about. With every cell cycle, a small amount of telomere gene will be lost. Okay, that means the chromosome from the ends, they will start to shorten. Okay, but finally what will happen, a stage will reach, okay, when all the telomere gene is lost and the chromosome ends cannot be protected now. Okay, such kind of chromosome without any telomere is called as a broken DNA. Okay, it is a broken DNA, and this will signal the cell cycle arrest. This is going to signal cell cycle arrest. So now the cell is going to achieve replicative senescence. That means a permanent non-dividing state. Okay. Let us move forward. Okay. Now this is again the same slide, but in this case we have added certain things. So this is something new. Okay, that I want to show you over here. Okay. So again, normally what happens that the telomere is encoding telomerase enzyme, and this telomerase enzyme is maintaining the telomere length. Okay, this is the normal process we have seen. Now, one important thing that I want to highlight actually is that the telomerase enzyme expression is directly proportional to the cell division. So the more the telomerase enzyme expression will be there, the more will be the cell division. Now look at this very nice graph that I have drawn. On the y-axis, if you look at the y-axis, I have taken the telomere length, and on the x-axis, I have taken the cell division. So over here, I have shown that normally all the somatic cells, okay, as they continue in their life, as they age, okay, what happens that the telomere length is coming down, okay, for the somatic cells, the telomere length is coming down, and slowly a stage is reached when the telomere length reduces to such an extent, okay, that the growth is arrested, as you can see. Sometimes what happens in neoplasia, okay, in cancers, in tumors, there is reactivation of the telomerase enzyme, and then what will happen, these somatic cells turn into tumor cells and they develop cancer. Okay, now telomere length is also maintained, but not to a very high extent in stem cells. I hope you all know what are stem cells. I have spoken about stem cells in my first lecture, in my lecture on cell as a health, cell as a unit of health and disease, chapter 1 of Robbins. And germ cells, okay, germ cells are the ones where the telomere length is completely maintained. They have increased expression of telomerase and they can undergo a lot of cell divisions. Okay, there is no cell arrest in case of germ cells. So just understand that somatic cells, okay, will undergo cell death much more earlier as compared to stem cells, and stem cells will undergo cell death much more earlier than germ cells. Okay, now let us move further. Okay, this is the same slide. Okay, just I will mark you the part which is new over here. Okay, now this is the part that I want to concentrate. Now I am reading about what are the clinical application, what is the clinical application of cellular senescence. Okay, what is the application that we are reading about is, so what is the application? So the application is, if you see telomerase enzyme, so if there is an increased activity of the telomerase enzyme, that means the cell division is going to continue, and this is very common in cancers. Number two, a decreased activity of the telomerase enzyme is seen in certain disease, for example pulmonary fibrosis and aplastic anemia. If this diagram has become very very confusing for you, let's go to the next slide. See, is this more better now? Absolutely, it is more better. If you can see the telomerase, if the activity is more, it will lead to cancer. If the activity is less, it will lead to pulmonary fibrosis and aplastic anemia. Let us move forward. Okay, now the second part of cellular senescence. First was telomere attrition. Second is activation of tumor suppressor gene. Let us move forward. Again, this is a very, very simple slide to understand. So activation of tumor suppressor gene. So what is the relation with the cellular senescence? So this is a gene that we can see. This is a gene, and inside this gene there is a certain part, an address, which is called as a locus. So locus kya hota hai? Locus is some address of a gene. Okay, so we are having in one locus of a gene, we have a gene called as CDKN2A gene, and this CDKN2A gene is encoding a protein called as P16. And what is the function of this P16? It controls the G1S phase and prevents uncontrolled cell division. Okay, so P16 puts a check to uncontrolled cell division, okay, and it drives the cell, it forces the cell to stop the cell division and go towards cellular senescence, okay. So these are the two ways how cellular senescence can occur, okay. Let us move forward. Achha, now the third leg, the third part which explains the aging process is the defect in protein homeostasis, okay. So let us see. Okay, this is again the previous slide only, but here we have added few things. Let us see. This is the part that we are going to concentrate in this particular slide. Okay, so whenever there is a defective protein homeostasis, okay, so first we have to understand what is the normal protein homeostasis, how normally the protein folding is regulated or protein metabolism is regulated. So we have already read this, you know this, okay. I will just mention this. Number one, maintenance of correctly folded protein. So we have seen, so whenever a new protein is synthesized, it is maintained, okay, it is maintained by chaperones. The folding of newly synthesized protein is maintained by the chaperone. So this is one mechanism which maintains the normal protein homeostasis. Another mechanism is degradation of the misfolded protein. So whatever is the misfolded protein, okay, whatever is the misfolded protein, okay, that has to be degraded. So we have seen in chapter number one that how this will be degraded. By two mechanism. One is autophagy mediated lysosome system will cause degradation of misfolded protein, and another one is ubiquitin proteasome system. Ubiquitin proteasome system. Okay. Now let us see one thing over here. Now, what is the clinical application of defective protein homeostasis? Let us look at the clinical application. So there are several mice studies. Okay, in mice studies they have seen whenever the chaperones are mutated, okay, just see, the chaperones were the ones which were normally responsible for maintaining the protein in a correct configuration, okay. If there is mutation in the chaperones, it can lead to a process of premature aging in mice. So there has been studies in the mice, okay. Now if you see conversely, if there is overexpression of chaperones, agar chaperones ka expression overexpression hota hai, it can lead to long life, okay, longer life in the mice. So I am repeating again, so in the mice studies we have seen whenever the chaperones undergo mutation, okay, there is a premature aging, and whenever there is overexpression of chaperones, the life increases, okay. Hope you have understood. Let us go forward. Okay, now the last leg of cellular aging is deregulated nutrient sensing. Let us see the deregulated nutrient sensing, what is it? Okay, so in very short term, I would like to explain you that deregulated sensing. So this theory of deregulated sensing actually tells us that if you eat less, you will live more. Okay, if you eat less, you will live more. So calorie restriction is going to increase the lifespan. So this is a very, very hot topic in today's world. Now, before we go into the details of deregulated nutrient sensing, first we have to understand the normal mechanism of nutrition in our body. So there are two very important neurohormonal regulation circuits in our body. Okay, one is insulin and insulin-like growth factor 1 signaling pathway, and another one is the sirtuins. So insulin and insulin-like growth factors, if you see, that the insulin, okay, like growth factor mimics the insulin in action. So what is the normal action of insulin like growth factor 1? They are going to promote an anabolic state, means cell ko build karna, okay, they will build the cell. Now this insulin like growth factor 1 is going to stimulate the downstream signaling pathways. What are the two main very basic downstream signaling pathways? Is the AKT pathway, and another one is your MAP kinase pathway. And both these pathways is going to stimulate growth and replication. They are going to stimulate growth and replication. Here I want to tell you a very basic thing. What the author has tried to tell us over here is that, see, if you are using, for example, if you are going to buy a second-hand car, okay, so the cost of the car will depend on how much kilometer the car has been driven. So if the car has been driven for around 10,000 kilometer, the cost will be very high. If the car has been driven for 30,000 kilometer, the cost will be slightly less. So as and when the body, the car is used, okay, depending upon how much the car has been used. For example, if you buy a car which has been driven for 1 lakh kilometers, okay, then the cost of the car will become very less because the value comes down because the car ages, okay, the car ages. Similarly, the same thing is in our body. If you eat a lot of food, you are going to stimulate this insulin and insulin-like growth factor pathway. And once you stimulate this pathway, our body will activate its machinery, okay, will signaling pathway, and there will be growth and replication. So the more you will use our, so the more food we eat, the more machinery of our body will be utilized and the more we will age. This is the basic mechanism. This is the basic logic, okay, behind this deregulated nutrient sensing. This is the first part. The second part is the sirtuins. So first of all, we will understand what sirtuins are. These are actually a family of deacetylases. There are 7 main types, okay? And these sirtuins actually, they are going to stimulate certain genes, and they are going, and these genes are going to make certain product, okay? And these product, what do they do? These product are going to inhibit metabolism. They are going to reduce apoptosis. They are going to stimulate protein folding. They are going to counteract reactive oxygen species, and they are going to increase the insulin sensitivity. So the whole idea, as we see, that is to reduce the body metabolism. The lesser will be the body metabolism, okay, the better it is. Okay, now let us look at the clinical application part. Okay, now let's look over here. So when we are not having food, when there is calorie restriction, two things is going to occur. First of all, the insulin-like growth factor pathway, okay, this signaling is going to come down, okay? If there is less signaling, again, there will be less cell growth and less metabolism, means our body machinery is not being utilized, okay? So the aging process is now slowed. Aging process is slowed, okay? Okay. Second thing is, whenever we are reducing the amount of calorie in our diet, okay, sirtuins, there is a group of enzymes called as sirtuins, proteins actually, especially sirtuin number 6, they increase. They actually stimulate the metabolic adaptations, okay, to reduce calorie intake. And the second most important thing is that they are going to stimulate the DNA repair enzymes. They are going to stimulate the DNA repair enzymes. There are many studies which states that red wine, okay, they stimulate the release of sirtuins, and indirectly they can increase the lifespan. Okay, they can increase the lifespan. Let us move ahead. So my question to my viewers is, first of all, this is just for educational purpose. Okay, this slide is just for educational purpose. I never endorse this. Just for educational purpose, I have kept this. So let us understand something. My question to my viewers is that, does red wine really activates the sirtuins and helps reverse the process of aging? This is a very big question. So there is a very big question mark over here, okay? There are many studies which claims, okay, but as of now, there is no concrete evidence that consuming red wine can help reverse the process of aging. So you keep this in mind. Going to our last slide for the day. This is a slide where I have just summarized all the 4 different mechanisms of aging. Okay, and we will see each one of them. Let us see. So I have already discussed that whenever there is carcinogen exposure, okay, or physical, chemical, biological agent, or there is a reactive oxygen species, it will lead to DNA damage, and then there will be accumulation of mutations, and finally it will promote cellular aging. The second mechanism that I explained was cellular senescence. Okay, that I have already explained. Whenever there will be telomere shortening, there will be decreased cell replication, and there will be cell loss, means the cell goes into replicative senescence, that is a permanent non-dividing state. The third part is defective protein homeostasis. Over here, what is there? There is a decreased amount of normal protein, and there's an increased amount of misfolded or damaged protein. Again, there is a decreased cell functions in this case. All these 3 processes, they will lead to cellular aging. They will lead to cellular aging. Okay. Now, whenever there is a nutrient sensing means that this is one mechanism, okay, sirtuins, means whenever there is a calorie restriction, The sirtuins will increase and the insulin and insulin-like growth factor signaling pathway is going to decrease. This will lead to an altered transcription, and in turn this will cause increased DNA repair and increased protein homeostasis, and they will counteract the aging process. Hope you have liked my video. Stay subscribed, stay tuned, and please share how you feel about this video in our comments. Thank you very much. Stay tuned. Good night.